A popular question I see is, does antivirus slow down my computer? And I've been wanting to do this video for a long time because it's almost been 2 years since I've done my last antivirus video. So for this one, I've teamed up with HP and Webroot so I can finally answer this question once and for all and find out how an antivirus really affects the computer's performance and if it's even worth having a security software on your PC. For this test, I wanted to use a laptop that was pretty powerful, but also fairly affordable at under $1,000, and this HP Pavilion Power 15 is a perfect fit. It's currently less than $1,000 on Amazon. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. So let's quickly go over the features and the specs so you can get an idea of what kind of machine this is. Even though HP does not officially label this as a gaming laptop, I like to label it as a budget gaming laptop because it can easily handle the majority of your gaming and media creation needs with no problem, but it does not have that crazy bulky gaming laptop look to it, and it doesn't have a hefty price tag like actual gaming laptops. It looks like your normal everyday notebook, but as the name implies, it packs some power. The exterior and interior of this laptop are pretty much blacked out, which gives it a cool, stealthy look to it. Inside the laptop, there is a 7th generation Intel Core i7-7700HQ 2.8 GHz processor, and having that kind of CPU will definitely help out when running apps in the background, such as antivirus. It has a relatively fast 7200 RPM 1TB hard drive. Now, I usually always prefer a solid state drive over a hard disk drive, but for most users with a budget in mind, it almost always makes more sense to go with a hard disk drive than a solid state drive just because they are much more affordable for how much storage you get in return. And if you do end up getting a hard disk drive in your laptop, just make sure it is a 7200 RPM hard disk drive and not anything lower, like at a 5400 RPM drive, because those are just so much slower and they will make you pull your hair out. So at the very least, I'm glad that this has a 7200 RPM hard drive in it. It also has 12 gigabytes of DDR4 RAM inside, along with a dedicated AMD Radeon RX 550 graphics card with 2 gigabytes of memory, which really comes in handy if you are gaming or doing any type of HD video editing on this machine. Now, even though it's not 4K, this laptop does have a great looking 15.6 inch WLED backlit full HD 1920 by 1080 resolution anti-glare IPS display, which is another highlight for gamers and anyone who watches videos or movies. I actually had 3 different screens set up on Saturday with a football game playing on each one, and this was one of them on the HP Pavilion Power 15, and I really enjoyed the way it looked on this screen just from the viewing angles. The way I had it set up on my desk, this was on the left, and I could watch the game with no problem from an angle, and it looked good. It looked crisp. It didn't have any problem with dropping frames or anything like that, so this display is pretty good for a 1080p display. It's got a nice full-size keyboard with chiclet-style keys that can be backlit, which is a useful feature for night owls. It's sporting dual speakers that have a decent sound, basically the quality of what you can expect out of a laptop in this price range. The trackpad is a nice size and is pretty wide. And last but not least, it has an HD webcam, 3 USB ports, along with a USB-C port, an HDMI port, an Ethernet port, and a media card slot. So now you're seeing why its slogan is creativity by day, high gear by night, because it's this unique blend of business productivity mixed with performance for basic gaming and digital creation. Now, to answer the question, does antivirus slow down a computer? I'm using the free PCMark benchmarking tool, and this software tests a bunch of different components and scenarios on your computer and then spits out a score, and it's a pretty good indicator of overall performance on a PC. And when I ran the PCMark test on this laptop without an antivirus, it scored a 3939. And what we're gonna do in a minute is install and test out the Webroot Internet Security Complete software and then run another PCMark test while that's running and compare the second score to the original score and see how much of an impact antivirus software has on a computer's performance. Now, before we get into that, I just wanna go over your best line of defense against viruses and malicious software, and that all starts with your own actions. So I always tell people, no matter what antivirus you're using, just make sure you follow these basic tips. First, make sure your computer is set to automatically install updates. Make sure you're regularly updating all your software that's on your computer. Make sure you're keeping a backup, an off-site backup, and you're backing up your data regularly to an off-site secure location. And third, make sure you're not clicking on any sketchy links or sketchy emails or downloading any sketchy software or clicking on sketchy pop-up ads. But even if you do all of those things right, it's still a good idea to have an antivirus software installed. It just adds that second layer of protection to keep you safe, because it still is easy to accidentally click on a malicious link or connect to an unsecure Wi-Fi network. Literally last Sunday night, my soon-to-be in-laws called me freaking out. They're like, I think we have some type of virus. Our computer is talking to us, and it's saying we have a Zeus virus, and it's saying that if we shut off our computer, we're going to lose all of our data, and all of our bank accounts are going to be hacked, and we're going to get our identity stolen. Now, of course, this was just a scam. It was a phishing scam. But for less tech-savvy people like that, this genuinely scares them and freaks them out, because that's what scammers do. They pop up these fake virus scams, and it basically instantly puts fear into the victims, and that's when the victims start making decisions based on fear. I cleaned up their system, it's all good now. But that got me thinking, a security software or antivirus should definitely help prevent something like that from happening, right? So I'm actually going to try to recreate that scenario right now and see if the Webroot Internet Security Complete will be able to thwart off that phishing scam. First, let me quickly go over why I think the security software is a good choice for this test. First, it's affordable. It's currently only $36 on Amazon for a 5-device, 1-year license. For an all-in-one security software solution, that's a pretty good deal. Second, it's gotten great reviews, not only from customers on Amazon, but from professional testers at PC Mag, who gave it an excellent rating. Now, Webroot claims that it installs 8 times faster than its average competitor, so we're gonna see how fast it installs on the HP Pavilion Power 15. The process is simple. Just visit the Webroot download page and it will download a small file, then just run the installer. Now, I've sped this up slightly just for the video's sake, but the total install time was 3.5 minutes. 2 minutes and 16 seconds of that was used for the initial scan, so it really only took about 1 minute and 15 seconds to download and install. Now, all of its main features should address everything that we've discussed so far. For security, it guards your personal information by blocking the latest malware and phishing attacks. It scans billions of apps, files, and websites continuously to determine what is safe online. It has a comprehensive real-time protection against the latest threats. It provides login protection by encrypting passwords, usernames, and credit card numbers. It even gives you an option of mobile security to protect your smartphone or tablet. For speed, it has fast scans with no abrasive interruptions. It's cloud-based, so it automatically stays up to date real-time, and it doesn't bog down your computer. Compared to its average competitor, Webroot claims it is 35 times smaller, can scan 60 times faster, and uses 15 times less memory. So if this is all true, then it should keep users safe without slowing them down, which is key for this video. And last but not least, backup. It comes with 25 gigabytes of secure online storage to back up your important data. That goes back to one of my main rules, and that is to be backing up your data consistently to an offsite secure location. Now, do not try this next thing at home. I'm doing this at my own risk. I'm gonna see if Webroot Internet Security Complete can prevent malware from getting onto this laptop. Hey Cortana, search the web for free Facebook game download. So I figured this was a great way to find a malicious site. I asked Cortana to find a free Facebook game download. And if we click on one of these sketchy search results, and of course it takes us to a scam, and ask us to download a piece of malicious software. And there you go, Webroot has instantly detected that this is an unsafe site and tells us to take us back to safety. And that's exactly what we wanted to see. It kept us safe in an unobtrusive way. I think that gets a thumbs up from me. Now finally, let's see what the PC Mark score is when we leave Webroot up and running while we perform the benchmark test. So the test is complete and it has scored a 3878. So it took a very tiny hit, only a 61 point difference, which is about a 1.5% impact based on the original score of 3939. So that brings us to the main question: does antivirus slow down your computer? Well, it honestly depends on what kind of antivirus and security software you're running, and also depends on your computer's specs, how fast your computer is. Obviously, anything running in the background that's actively running like an antivirus is going to have some type of impact on your computer's performance, but the big question is, does the antivirus slow down your computer in such a way that negatively impacts the user's experience? With something like Webroot Internet Security Complete, as you've seen, one of its main selling points is how lightweight and unobtrusive it's designed to be. So the best advice is, yes, it's always a good idea to have antivirus on your computer and try to get something that is not designed to take up a lot of computer's resources. And if it does, make sure you have a powerful enough machine like the HP Pavilion Power 15 so that you get a good balance of protection and performance for what you are trying to do specifically on your computer. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something new, and I hope you were introduced to some products that you may not have heard of. Big shout out to HP and Webroot for sponsoring this video, and thank you for watching. My name is Andy. I'll talk to you in the next one.